Hi everyone, and welcome to another Getting Started with Canvas screencast. This time, I'm going to review Canvas's syllabus tool. The syllabus tool in Canvas is a great tool. Let's take a look. The tool is designed so that I can easily add my syllabus policies and other details, and then allow Canvas to build my schedule when I post assignments and events to the calendar. At the top of my syllabus, Canvas provides a rich content editor. Using this editor, I can copy and paste my syllabus text, or I can provide a link to my syllabus document. At the bottom of the page, Canvas provides a dynamic schedule. Canvas builds and updates this schedule based on information I add or change on the course calendar or in assignments. The third part of the syllabus, on the right-hand side of the page, is a mini calendar. On the mini calendar, if I see a date that's shaded, I can click on it, and the syllabus will take me to the event or assignment associated with that day. The syllabus will also show a list of assignment groups and the grade weighting scheme if I've weighted my assignments. The best way to learn about the syllabus tool is to use it. So now I'll give you a demonstration of the way it works. Let's say that I've worked on my syllabus and my course schedule, and I've got documents close to final drafts. With these documents in hand, I'm ready to add my syllabus to Canvas. I know I want students to have a copy of my syllabus. I want them to not only see the syllabus, but I also want them to be able to download it. The easiest way to make this happen in Canvas is to edit syllabus description. From here, I could type or copy and paste the text of my syllabus into the rich content editor. But since my syllabus is already typed out and formatted the way I want it, and saved as an accessible PDF, I really just want to link to it, and I can do that here. So I'll just add a little bit of text like, "Be sure to read your syllabus," and then I'll add a link to my syllabus. To add the link, I go to Insert Content into this page and select Files because I want to upload my syllabus file. I know my syllabus file isn't in the course files yet, and so I'll go to upload a new file. When I do this, I get the option to browse and look for the file. And then I'll select my syllabus and click open. I can see and confirm the file I selected next to the browse button in Canvas. To finish, I click upload. The file name now appears in my content editor, and for a moment, I see a golden box around the file name. That's a very good sign. It indicates that the file is uploaded and that the link is now active. This process gives me a link that students can use to download the file, but to embed the file, I'll click one time to place my cursor in the middle of the file name. In my Rich Content Editor menu, there's a very small link icon. I'll click on that button. I'll see a pop-up box that includes the selection, auto-open the inline preview for this link. I want a preview, so I'll check this box. And then click Update Link. My link turns gold again, which is what I'm looking for. Finally, I'll scroll to the bottom of the page and update syllabus. This may take a moment, but soon I'll see a panda riding a unicycle. And right after that, I'll see my syllabus preview. Students can now read the syllabus online, and if they like, they can also download the syllabus from here. Now that you see how to embed a PDF, know that you can repeat this process of uploading and embedding external files, including Word docs, PDFs, and PowerPoint presentations, whenever you have a rich content editor in Canvas. Okay, my syllabus document is in place. Now let me show you how Canvas generates the schedule. The syllabus tool works in tandem with the calendar and with assignments. This means that when I enter assignments or events into the course calendar, those events will show up here in the syllabus schedule. To demonstrate, I'll go to the course calendar. First, I want to be sure that I'm viewing the correct calendar for this course. Remember, the calendar shows all of my courses and my personal calendar. So, to be sure that I'm adding an event and assignments to this course, it would be best to deactivate all of the other course calendars. I do this by just clicking on the little colored box next to the course. When that course and the little box is gray, then that course calendar is deactivated. Now that that's done, I'll start by adding an event to this course. I'll go to the beginning of the term and to the first day of class. When I click on the first day of the term, I get a pop-up box that gives me a choice to add an event or an assignment. I want to make the first day of class an event. I'll add that my class begins at 11 a.m. and goes until noon. And then I also add a location. My class meets in the Clark Building, C143. And I'll double check that I'm adding all of this to the correct calendar. I see that I can add other information here, but for the moment, I'll leave the event as is. Hopefully, you're thinking about how you can use this tool to add other events to your course. Now I'll add some assignments. In week one, I'll have an in-class writing assignment due on Wednesday. I'll make this an assignment with the title In-Class Writing, number 1. I've already selected the due date by clicking on the calendar, and I'm pretty confident that I'm in the right calendar, but I'll double check. For now, this assignment will go into the default assignments group, and I'll go ahead and publish the assignment. I can add more options, the details of the assignment, but since this is a placeholder for my assignment, I'm done for now. Moving on, I'll add a homework assignment that will be due on Monday of the second week of class. And finally, I'll add a draft of essay number 1 that will be due on Friday at the end of the second week of class. Now that I've used the calendar to add the due dates for an event and some assignments, let's see what Canvas has done with this information elsewhere in the course. Let's look first at assignments. You can see here in assignments that Canvas has generated the full assignment we'll need based on what I did in the calendar, which is a great start. I can come back here later and fill out the details of each of these assignments. So, getting back to the syllabus, another thing I can set up now is the grade weighting scheme that's part of my syllabus. I have the course set up so that I have 3 major assignment types throughout the term. I have in-class writing, I've got homework, and I have essays. In order to weight my assignments, I have to create these 3 assignment groups first. From within assignments, I'll add these 3 assignment groups. First, in-class writing, then homework, and finally, essays. Now that I have my major assignment groups, I'll move the assignments I created into each group. And I can delete the default assignment group. And now I can set the weights for my groups. I'll go to the assignment settings, the little gear icon at the top of the assignments page, and I'll select Weight final grade based on assignment groups. My syllabus says 25% for in-class writing, 25% for homework, and 50% for essays. Okay, the work I've done so far, establishing what assignments will be due and when, and then weighting the major assignment groups, is all based on details from my syllabus and my schedule. So let's take a look at how Canvas has taken these details and added them to the syllabus. Let's return to the course syllabus. I see that below my syllabus, I now have a schedule that includes a listing of events and assignments, including important dates and links to more information. I also have the little calendar that shows some subtle visual reminders, and I see my assignment groups and their relative weights. Note that by working with my syllabus, I have been building my overall course structure. When I get into filling out the details of the assignments and the rest of the course, I'll probably make some changes. The great news about the syllabus and the tools connected to the syllabus is that as long as I don't put any dates in my text or in PDF documents, anytime I update an event or an assignment date in one place, those updates are reflected everywhere else in the course, including the dynamic schedule in the syllabus. It's also great to know that whenever you make an update in Canvas, students will automatically be notified of these syllabus and schedule changes. For more information about the Canvas Syllabus tool, take a look at the set of syllabus guides in Canvas's Help Center.